Salamat sa Panginoon at magkasama na naman tayo para sa pag-aaral ng salita ng Diyos. I am really blessed to be given this opportunity to share with you something from the Word of God every Thursday. Well, here's our verse for this morning. Matthew chapter 8, verses 16 to 17. And they reasoned among themselves, saying, "It is because we have no bread." But Jesus, being aware of it, said to them, "Why do you reason because you have no bread? Do you not yet perceive nor understand? Is your heart still hardened?" Now I need you to imagine this. There was this group of friends who just left a gathering of people, more than 5,000, okay, more than 5,000 people. They just left that amazing gathering and they were setting sail on the Sea of Galilee. As they were journeying, they realized wala pala silang baon. Wala pala silang pagkaing dala. They had no bread. And this was, you know, this was no small matter. As the journey could be lengthy. It could take a long time, and it could be a difficult journey, because sometimes bumabagyo po, no? Umuulan, bumabagyo sa kanilang paglalayag sa Sea of Galilee. Let's continue with the story, okay? Balikan natin yung large gathering na iniwan nila. I know you're familiar, many of you are familiar with this story. At that large gathering, what happened there? Yung iniwan nila na gathering, Jesus had been teaching and preaching to the crowd. When those 5,000, I believe they are more than 5,000, because Jesus had been going on for the whole day, the people became hungry. So to make the long story short, in that gathering, which I call an amazing gathering, Jesus took 5 loaves and 2 fish that were available, and what he did was he multiplied it such that everyone on the hillside was fed. Lahat nakakain. Okay? There were even 12 baskets full of leftovers. So it was an incredible miracle, above duplication of the feeding of the 5,000 and their families. Such an amazing, miraculous gathering. Now, tignan natin yung group of men na ito, the disciples of Jesus Christ. This group of men, nagmamadali silang umalis. Nagmamadali silang bumiyahe. In their haste, they had forgotten to bring any provision for the journey. Wala silang baon. Na-discover na lang nila, siguro nung nandun na sila sa kalagitnaan. And the irony of this scene is that Jesus, who had just miraculously fed a crowd of 5,000 only minutes before, this miracle worker was with them in the boat. He was sitting in that very boat, and Jesus was listening to these concerns, listening to them worried about where are we gonna get food, where are we gonna get bread. We're in the middle of the Sea of Galilee already. Siguro si Jesus Christ, ano, sumakit siguro yung ulo ni Jesus Christ sa pakikinig sa kanila. He had to be shaking his head. He could not believe what's happening sa kanyang mga disciples. He just performed a miracle. He just fed 5,000. In fact, kung babalikan natin yung Bible message, Bible text natin ngayong umaga, Jesus responds to these men, to his disciples, Look at your Bible. He said something like this. Do you not yet see or understand? Do you have a hardened heart? You and I can be so similar to those disciples in that boat. Kung minsan parang nangyayari rin sa atin ito eh. Minsan ganito rin tayo mag-behave. You know, how often have we experienced some miraculous circumstance, whether we credit Jesus or not? After natin ma-experience ang isang miracle, the next thing that happens is that we turn right around and we whine, we complain, we worry about some other area of our lives, some concern. You know, we so quickly forget the blessings. We so quickly forget the miraculous and the mighty acts of God in our lives. We forget the blessings we've experienced, and we easily allow doubt and fear to dominate our current situation rather than resting in the fact that Jesus is with us, that Jesus is journeying with us, that Jesus is right there in the boat of life with us. Jesus has already proven himself trustworthy to be found when we truly seek him, and to never leave us or forsake us. Jesus even said this about himself, that he is the bread of life. He is completely satisfying. He is sufficient. If we could only rest and trust in that fact, mas magiging masaya, mas magiging maganda ang ating buhay. My friend, brethren, if you're struggling to trust Jesus, I want to encourage you that Jesus is who he says he is. But he does not force us to trust him. He allows that decision to be a deliberate act of your free will. Beloved in the Lord, will you take your eyes off the problem in your life? Will you take your eyes off these problems you have right now and look to Jesus? Look to Jesus, the Good Shepherd, the Jehovah Jireh, our all in all. See him. Get to know him, soften your heart to his presence, because he's right there with you in the boat. He's right there. I hope that would bring encouragement to us and also confidence as we face this day. God be with you. Have a blessed day.
Christ alone.